सदाशिवसमारम्भाम् शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis sitting with us around the world at this moment in 654 places through NTV, 24 places to be in Ayanadiksha, in 177 cities in 20 countries. Today the first question, Swamiji, what is spiritual healing? Can you explain the way we can understand? First, I wanted to say few basic truths about the spiritual healing. Scientifically, see, the other day I was reading an article by Dr. Bruce Lipton, who has done some of the breakthrough scientific discoveries connecting the science and spirituality. In his article, he is quoting a term called entanglement from quantum physics. In quantum physics, there is a term entanglement. Means, when one energy source entangles with another, they interfere with each other. This interference can be highly positive and transformative and harmonious. Please understand, if one energy source comes in contact with another, if one energy source entangles with another, they interfere with each other. That interference can be harmonious and highly positive and transforming. Another one, physicist Amit Goswami, he published an article in Physics Journal. In that, he very clearly proves entanglement directly affects human beings. Please understand, entanglement affects human beings. There are thousands of examples for entanglement. If you have some 200 pendulum clocks put on one wall, the wall can be any length. It does not need to be within certain length. It can be like China wall, any length. If you have few hundred pendulum clocks, even if it is a long wall, put hundreds of pendulum clocks and start them all at different times. See, within next few minutes, all the pendulums will swing in synchronicity. Exactly, this is what happens when you come in the breathing space of the healer, please understand, when you come in my breathing space, this is what happens. Suddenly, your mind gets entangled with my no mind. I wanted to tell you, entanglement is only in the thought level. If your mind entangles with my no mind, it is entanglement, thought level. Next, please understand, if your muscle memory gets entangled with my muscle memory, that is called entrainment. If your bio memory gets entangled with my bio memory, it's called enlightenment. Entanglement can move to entrainment, then entrainment can become enlightenment. You need to know a few things. How this healing happens. See, healing happens in the entanglement level. Kundalini awakening happens in the entrainment level. Levitation happens in deeper than entrainment. I can say momentary enlightenment. This is very important truth. This truth about the entanglement, because this opens many doors, many possibilities, many understandings. How I heal through healers? Because all my healers are pendulum clocks. Any other broken, little altered pendulum clock, I add it in one wall. Both clocks start swinging synchronistically. Understand? That's all. Each one of my healer is my pendulum clock. If you are little broken, disturbed pendulum clock, if both are hung in one breathing space, your pendulum also starts vibrating, moving. The same tune. And a living, practicing healer, please understand, living, practicing healer is continuously in entanglement with me. He may be wherever he is. A living, practicing healer is continuously in entangled with me. This is what I call physiology of feeling connection. A practicing healer, a healer who lives whatever I am teaching, as long as he retains the feeling connection, the very physiology becomes different. Entanglement means two person falling in tune with same thought. Entrainment means two person falling in tune with the same idea. Enlightenment means two person uniting beyond ideas. When you unclutch, you are in entangle with me. You are in entanglement with me. This again opens a huge door, then is the thoughts of a healer going to affect us? I say yes. That is why I am telling you, go to a person only who is thoughtless and beyond mind. Do not receive healing from ordinary Reiki healers, this healers, that healers. No. Receive only from enlightened being. And all my healers, during the moment of healing, because they are entangled with me, they represent me, and it is equivalent to you receiving healing directly from me. You don't need to worry at all, doubt at all about my healers. Understand? This is the physiology of feeling connection. When you have a feeling connection, your very physiology is different. And feeling connection has its own physiology. When you have a feeling connection, your physiology is different. Feeling connection itself has its own physiology. One more thing you need to know, all the doctors, even allopathy doctors, need to raise their energy level high. Otherwise, when you treat the patient, when the patient feels respectful, feeling connection with you, you are going to entangle yourself with the patient. If you don't raise your energy to the higher level, you are going to get the patient's disease to you. Understand, entanglement can be negative also. If you are not energetic enough to protect yourself, if you do not have a direct protection of an enlightened being or higher frequency, if you don't have higher entanglement, only lower entanglements in your life, you are bound to fall sick. In the grown-up countries, they are suffering because they are not able to dispose the garbage. One city collects from the whole city and dumps it to another one village. That village collects and dumps it to another one village. They collect it and dump it in another one city. Same way only the so-called grown-up societies are suffering, unable to dump the inner garbage. The housewife collects everything and dumps on the husband. Husband collects everything and dumps on the psychiatric doctor. Psychiatric doctor collects and dumps everything on another one, his size psychiatric doctor. His psychiatric doctor do not know where to go and dump. The dumping garbage has become a big problem for the humanity in grown-up countries. Not only external, internal also. In India, fortunately, we know how to reduce the garbage into ashes without any side effect or after effect, without leaving anything affecting the environment. Method of dumping the inner garbage without creating any societal, environmental pollution, side effect and after effect is deity worship. Each deity energized which went through the prana pratishtha process is in entanglement with the higher consciousness. That is what I prove when I materialize. See, when a devotee can receive vibhuti or kumkum and materialize, same thing, the deity also receives vibhuti, kumkum and materializes. How? When somebody's kundalini is awakened, when somebody is initiated as a healer, is in entanglement with me, same way the deity is also in entanglement with me. Once the prana pratishtha is done, that deity is continuously in entanglement with that super consciousness. Ramanatha Swami is in entanglement with Sri Ramachandra, and the consciousness Sri Ramachandra experienced, which is Shiva himself. Because Ramanatha Swami installed, Rama installed that Ramanatha Swami in Rameshwaram. Now the Ramanatha Swami is in entanglement with Rama and Rama's pure inner consciousness. Same way there is a deity called Krishneshwar in Dwaraka, installed and worshipped by Krishna. That deity is in entanglement with Krishna and the Krishna's inner space, which is Shiva himself. Same way in Tiruvannamalai, there is a temple called Adi Annamalai. Please understand, the main Arunachaleshwara temple is Jiva Samadhi of Arunagiri Yogishwara. But the Adi Annamalai temple is the deity installed by Arunagiri Yogishwara for his own personal worship when he was in the body. Understand that Adi Annamalai temple, small temple in the forest. Now it has become a small village, and the Shivalinga in the temple is in entanglement with Arunagiri Yogishwara and of course Shiva himself. Arunagiri Yogishwara is Shiva himself, came in the physical form. So each deity is in entanglement with the consciousness which has installed it. That is why I am telling you, deity worship is one of the greatest garbage removing system, inner garbage removing system created by our ancient rishis. The whole Western country, so-called developed countries, are suffering with unable to do the garbage removal. They are spending billions of dollars in the inner garbage removal, creating huge psychiatrists and psychoanalysts, this therapy, that therapy. Any foolishness you talk in a very systematic way becomes one more therapy. Now something called, newly developing, called pet therapy. Having a pet is a therapy, because you constantly care for the pet and take care, your attention gets diverted from the stress and that heals. God, where all finally you have to find healing, you see. Instead of finding from God, you find from dog. The East, we do God therapy. There, they do dog therapy. And having dog is very high culture. And having God or your own Ishta Devata is superstitious. 32.4%. 75 million Americans are suffering from clinically provable mental disorder every year. Please understand. Who needs clinical attention. I am not even talking about the borderline personalities. You know borderline personality means? They will look almost all right. Till you touch one of their wrong engram. Just one engram. When they come, you did not smile or you smiled at somebody else and said Nityanandam, over. I am not even talking about borderline personalities. People who need direct clinical attention. Medical attention. 75 million. See the garbage disposal problem. In the Vedic tradition, we know how to burn the garbage and make it as a manure. All our temples, we burn your garbage, internal garbage, and transform you, make the whole garbage into manure and give it back to you. Means you go to temples only when you have a problem or to feel little stress-free? No. When you finish your business accounts, go to temple and offer your gratitude. When you finish some of your life-related decisions, go to temple and offer the gratitude. If you have finished building the house, go to the temple, offer the gratitude. If you got married, go to the temple, offer the gratitude. Any major events in your life connected with the temple, even entertainment, entrainment, enlightenment, everything should happen with entanglement. I'm creating a new word, entemplement. Life should become entemplement because that is the easiest way of clearing the inner garbage. I don't know why this human beings are still not understanding. You don't know the Western countries, how many billions of dollars they are spending every year creating medicines, psychiatric doctors and the infrastructures. Every county will have at least one psychiatric care center or hospital, doctor. Entanglement. It's the most powerful way. Entangling yourself with an enlightened being is the most easiest and powerful way to raise yourself to the higher level and get enlightened. I can give you a simple technique to have entanglement with me. Just morning, sit in the satsang, that's all. Every day morning satsang itself is entanglement with me. Understand? The science of entanglement, entrainment and enlightenment proves the spiritual healing. See, in the entanglement level, physical healing happens. In the entrainment level, mental transformation happens. In the enlightenment level, conscious explosion happens. If you are in the entanglement level, just physical healing happens. If you are in the entrainment level, means muscle memory, doing what I am saying, the transformation happens. If you are in the enlightenment level, just melting, the very mystical doors of life opens and the enlightenment, conscious explosion happens. And my every satsang is programmed I can say entanglement enabled. When you open any one of my satsang, we should make a word, entanglement enabled. The constant entanglement happens. That is why many times the ideas which you never heard directly from my mouth or from the discourse, you will be telling to others. You would have heard only 5 ideas. But when you expand it to others, explain it to others, when others question you, you will have 25 ideas coming out of you. You may be thinking, where did I get this? Entanglement. If you get 5 ideas from me verbally and talk 10 to others, you are in entanglement level. If you get only 1 idea from me and talk 100 to others, you are in entrainment level. You just saw me and started exploding. You are in enlightenment level. Entanglement is a very important basic truth. You need to understand the science of healing. This levitation, kundalini awakening, everything happens just through this great truth of entanglement. Nothing else. Understand, when you are in entanglement with me, I give my inner space to you, which is lighter than the outer space. I'll explain in a very detailed way the science of levitation through this great truth of entanglement. Understand? Kadakasha means your, the inner space you have inside your body. Chidakasha, the space in which your body is sitting. Parakasha, the cosmic sky, cosmic space. If your inner space is more heavy, dirty with more matter, mass. Matter, mass means thoughts. If it is more heavy than the Chidakasha, your outer space, you will be grounded. Very strong. Fixed. Glued to the ground. All I do is, for few minutes, a few seconds, I make your inner space lighter than the outer space by removing the mass, dirt. Means those few seconds you are in entanglement with my inner space, purest consciousness. Because your inner space loses its mass, dirt, weight, the body just starts jumping, hopping, levitating. But this is only initiation. By and by, after a few times, your inner space starts believing, oh God, thoughtless light space is possible for me. That is my nature. But because of my habit, I am habituated to live in a heavy, clouded, space, heavy, loaded space, I can be in thoughtless space. That is my nature. That is my original nature. That will be that will become experience in you if you are constantly initiated and exposed to the pure inner space. Then once you are exposed to that, by and by your biomemory, muscle memory, inner space, everything starts enjoying that space and starts living in that space, it becomes living enlightenment. This is the way the entanglement becomes entrainment, entrainment becomes enlightenment. Entanglement is initiation. Every entanglement I made is an endowment I created. Now you need to live it to make it as enlightenment. I bless you all who are sitting with us around the world at this moment in 1050 places through NTV, 24 places to way Nayana Diksha, in 250 cities in 23 countries. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, share, and explode in eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.